Oh. See, Miss Nasty, when you when you're dancing, and in a club, and you do this here, when you turn your back on the man, and you're doing the nasty. See, once you do that, then see, I was standing up there. Watch out, Miss Nasty. Watch yourself. Watch yourself, Miss Nasty. I said, boy, that show ain't gonna look good. Especially when they run that tape down in Bible study. Oh, Lord. Miss Nasty, you ain't bad, girl. Name something a man's mistress does that would make him want to go home to his wife.
A little dirty, stinky in the little area there.
Oh. Hygiene.
Bad hygiene. Miss Sharon, name something on your body you're glad you only had one of.
My butthole, Steve.
Point value's triple. Top four answers on the board. We asked 100 women, name something a girl can never have too many of.
Orgasms.
Orgasms. Name something it would be weird for twins to share.
Private parts. That's weird, Steve.
This is why it's hard for all male teams to win. It's answers like this that throw us back. Private parts. Name something, Joe, that squirts when you least expect it.
Well, Steve, at my age, my privates. Yeah, baby! Oh! Good answer! Oh! Good answer! Yeah, baby! Come on, you like that. I know you like that. Come on. Come on,
hey,
now.
Joe.
Come
hey,
on,
Joe.
Now.
Joe, you walk in here and go, no. Whoa,
right. Table, ooh!
That's twice. I got to get that. The hell is that bad? It's privates. Yeah! Tell me a gift you might give to your girlfriend you'd never give to your mom.
We're gonna go with a child.
Now, let me tell you something. Your whole damn family gonna be on YouTube. Five grown-ass black people set in a huddle and came out the huddle. A child. Name a place where you see lots of people who make you realize your body isn't so bad after all.
The bathroom. Never took a little peek.
I never took a little peek. You're not supposed to do that. Hey, Kevin, that's rule number one of manhood. Once you're facing that wall, handling your business, you cannot do this. It's against the rules. Something a woman hopes isn't in a man's mustache.
Other hair.
What other kind of hair could you be talking about?
Just this hair.
This hair.
Maybe somewhere else. Oh, wasn't supposed to. to go this way.
I know all this gonna play good back in Utah.
What he came up with.
That's what you came up with. No, that's what he came up with. Some hair. That's right. Grandma might say whenever Grandpa gets cranky, I just give him what?
A free pass to sleep with his best friend's cousin.
What? Up to 100 men, name something of yours you wouldn't want to shrink.
Nothing personal, but I say hairline.
Hairline.
Yeah, nice. Yeah, yeah.
Amelia, name something that's painful to do if you have a raging cold sore on your lip.
Eat ketchup.
Eat ketchup.
It's time.
Pass or play?
Oh, we're playing.
Oh, no doubt. What do you do, man?
I'm an account executive for ASC Direct. We're a service-disabled, veteran-owned small business. And I don't know if they told you, but I'm also business-licious. See, let me explain it to you, Steve. See,
stop right there.
You know what, stop, okay.
And then come talking about, I'm delicious. Now, see, what you ain't finna do, big fella, is look me in my eye and have the word delicious come out your damn mouth. Now, cause you're not, you might be delicious to her, but you don't be damn
That's
thing
me.
To me. And I'm gonna need you to fix this right now. We looking at each other, he talking about, I don't know if they told you or not. Damn, but I'm delicious.
Explain, Steve.
Well, big boy, I let me out news for you. You ain't delicious to me. Go
let me,
ahead, explain.
Let me
it,
explain,
right.
Steve.
Yeah, okay.
See, I got the business persona in the front. See this? That's business. But when you turn around, I'm delicious. It's working, ain't it? It's working. It's working. Yeah.
You know what?
What's that?
I think I see it. Kirk, how you doing?
Doing fine, sir.
What do you do, man?
I'm in the funeral industry. Be the last man to ever let you down.
You went to Tennessee, mm-hmm. Whitewater rafting.
Your family went whitewater rafting.
Yeah.
For what?
For
what,
fun.
What, are y'all crazy? That ain't fun.
Well, yeah. The water ain't that deep.
Why can't the water ain't deep when you turn over, you bust your head on that rock?
You ain't got to worry about us doing it again.
Oh,
that was one and done. That was one and done.
Oh, that's
that was it.
What happened, Brad?
Somebody hit a rock and got turned over.
What'd I just say?
One and done.
Yeah, what y'all gonna try next? Bungee jumping?
Skydiving. We already did.
Skydiving. Y'all went skydiving too? Stop this foolishness. So you can get to 55, okay?
Appreciate it.
What are you in school?
Yes, sir.
What are you studying? You're
radiology.
In college?
Studying radiology.
Radiology?
Yes, sir.
This is a bright family here.
Thank you.
Yeah, I like that, man. Everybody's got great careers, man. You're established, man. Stop all that whitewater rafting and skydiving. You might live to be something in this family right here. Don't ever, did you go skydiving?
No, sir.
Did you go whitewater rafting?
Yes, sir.
You went there. Did you like it?
Yes, sir.
You did. You going back?
No, never.
Let's do it, baby. Well, let's meet everybody, Michael.
Thank you. Okay. Well, I have here my very versatile brother, Vernon. My my cousin, Ika.
Vernon.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, Steve.
Mr. You Hall. All right?
Yes, sir. Yeah. I'm just excited to be here.
Excited?
A little excited.
Excited or scared?
It's a thin line.
This is my brother, Vernon.
I want to make sure.
Vernon, everything okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, looked a little startled when he said your name to you.
I wasn't ready. I wasn't.
I know. Vernon had that look like he had warrants. Name someone at a wedding you'd be surprised to see crying. Aaron.
I'm going with...
Taylor.
The groom.
The groom. Taylor turned around. Auntie, shut up. Try to talk to this man. The groom.
I'm sorry.
Miss Debbie, talk to 100 married people. Something you've caught your spouse doing in the middle of sex.
Well, maybe somebody else's. I'm not liking this. I'm sorry.
Ken, is this,
my wife, Debbie.
Your wife, Debbie? Debbie?
She is my third and favorite wife.
She's your third and favorite wife.
That's correct.
I know exactly what you mean.
Thank you.
Man.
Thank you, sir.
I thank you for saying it, man, out loud. Oh, we're gonna have to get us a club.
This is my beautiful mother, Charlene.
That's your mother?
That is my mother.
What?
Yes.
Girl, you from good genes. Your mama fly.
You know.
I just said you from good genes, your mama fly. That's all I said. Mike, you ain't got to slow me down, man. I ain't disrespectful towards nothing. Did I say anything disrespectful? I was very complimentary. Of course, I didn't know Mike was married to her, because Mike looked like her daddy.
Oh, my God.
Good. What do you do for a living, man?
I pick up guts from slaughterhouse and,
What's happening here?
This is the south side of Chicago.
You work at a slaughterhouse.
I drive and I pick up the slaughterhouse for rendering at Chicagoland's biggest rendering service, Kaluzny Brothers.
Yeah.
And they make makeup and stuff out of it.
Well, ladies, what's on your face? Jane, what do you do for a living?
I am a second grade school teacher.
Okay, good.
To the mighty hedgehogs. And then we have a hedgehog salute. That means shut up and stop talking and sit down.
It's one over here, too. Hey, Leland, how you doing?
I'm all right, man. How you doing?
Good. What you do for a living?
Well, I'm a father, single father of three kids. Lovely Cassandra, Leland Jr.
Oh, you're a single father?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I got to get you somebody today.
I ain't legal yet, but when I am legal, any of y'all that look good can call me.
Listen to me, Leland, listen to me. You ain't been out there in a while.
No.
See, you've been having three kids, you've been married.
Yeah.
See, you're a little bit deep.
Yeah.
You can't go into it looking thirsty. But anybody out there, all y'all that look good can come to see me. Women just going, Hey, Leland, we talked to 100 men. Name something that rises when it gets hot.
Your sexual parts, man.
Yeah, that's what I thought you was gonna say.
Hey, hold on.
Miss Jackie, you knew that the little nasty Leland was gonna be the first one to get it. I was bound to come out. I knew it was gonna be Leland, though. Doggone shame. Sexual parts. What do you do, darling?
I am a homemaker, and I have two children, and I make my own bread and raise chickens. Well, three chickens, not really a ton of them.
Now, let's talk about them chickens, though. You raise chickens.
I raise three chickens. Mm-hmm. We named them. They're pretty much pets. And we just get their eggs. Yeah, we don't eat them. We eat chicken, but we don't eat these chickens.
No, you ain't chicken. I mean, no, I was on a different farm. If you don't lay enough eggs, then
you become dinner.
We frying you. I had chickens in there just cranking eggs out. How you doing, Mr. Harvey? Yeah. Single, 28, got a good job, benefits.
Got benefits, got a master's degree.
Got a master's degree.
Hey, try to be like you.
Man, y'all are young. You trying to be like me, you done dropped out a long time ago. All right, here we go. Talk to 100 men. Name something you don't want to see fall on the ground when a woman takes off a bra.
Well, pads. Like her. Her maximum. Like I'm not sure why they put it there, but.
See, that'll.
Is that the same as tissue?
Well, you know, the same as tissue, same as stuffing. You know, you got that master's degree, you should have. Should have focused on a couple other things while you was getting your education. All right, here we go. Top 8 answers on the board. Can you reach it? Okay.
I'm a regional marketing manager for an insurance company in Iowa, but I'm also aspiring on my night times to be a sock model.
A what?
Sock model.
Sock.
From up here, here on up is through. So I thought, let's just focus on the sock.
I love men, because we just get real with it. From here on up, it's through. I just thought I'd focus on the socks. Let me see what you got on, man. You a sock model.
That was a good walk. Good walk.
I love people. Yeah, it was a good walk.
Okay, well, hold it in. Hold it
all
in.
All right. Is it DeQuil?
It's DeQuil.
DeQuil, how you doing? What
I'm
are you
good,
doing?
I'm good. I'm a business consultant for a information systems company.
All right, DeQuil, we're going.
Uh-huh.
I'm gonna ask the same question.
Okay.
Again. Try not to look like you making this up.
Okay.
All right, DeQuil. So what do you do for a living?
I'm a business consultant for a for information systems company.
Yeah, that's you.
Okay.
DeQuil, that's now officially a lie.
All right.
Okay. Miss Margaret, what does he do?
That's my firstborn.
Yes, ma'am, and what
does he do?
He
is a consultant rep.
Find something a woman should do very carefully if she isn't wearing any underwear.
She should be careful when she walking up the steps, Steve.
You know, I was just about to compliment him, tell him how proud I was of him and how I thought that was a wonderful answer because it has a strong chance of being up there. And then I looked over there, and right before I could get it out.
That's it. Yeah.
Careful walking up the stairs. Annie, how you doing today? That's
I'm
good.
Doing great.
Doc. Must be the answer you're about to give. Let's hear it. Name someone at a wedding you'd be surprised to see Brad French kissing.
Oh, her father?
Yeah, good answer. Yeah. Why not?
Her father? That's ugly. Name something you might need two of if you're cheating on your spouse.
Two man parts.
Two man parts.
She
go bob it on me, it's, you know.
Oh, she gonna rain a bob it on you. You gonna need that other one. Okay. Well, no, the Chris ain't cheating. There you go. Two man parts. We ask 100 women, name something you see on a man's face that would make you not want to kiss him.
Well, if he was Steve Harvey, maybe not, but a mustache.
Yeah.
I don't understand.
Well, any smart woman would want to kiss you, but, you know.
I just tell Toledo.
In general, I'm just saying, in general, a mustache.
You know, need to try it sometime. Don't knock it. You never know. Don't want to kiss him if he's got a mustache on his face. Name something a man wears at home that his wife won't let him wear in public.
Bob. G-string.
G-string. Wow, okay, Bob, what's happening at your house? All right, Bobby. Hey, Bobby. All right. Something jumping off at the house. Oh, Bobby got G-string. Hey, name something that an 80-year-old man who marries a 20-year-old woman might need.
I'm a church-going woman.
Wow.
But I would think he might possibly have a rather large member.
What church you go to? Oh, blown crazy. The man with the whatever she said. We ask 100 men, what's your worst physical flaw?
Don't take offense, but lack of hair.
Lack of hair.
Yeah.
What's your worst physical flaw?
I'm gonna go with the penis size.
We ask 100 men. So now imagine, I'm in the mall, here comes okay. Marshawn. I go, Marshawn, would you mind taking a survey? Let me ask you something, Marshawn. What's your worst physical flaw? How many men is gonna turn to a total stranger, taking a survey in a mall and go, be perfectly honest with you, I'm not packing at all. The thing is too small. Yeah. Hey Nick, 100 men, name something Shaquille O'Neal has that's bigger than yours.
I'm gonna go with hands.
He's got, well, that's a body part. That's a body
part. I'm gonna go with junk.
Good answer, Eric. Good answer, good answer.
That's all body parts? That's totally separate. I got news for you. When a guy refers to a little, I gotta tell you, I know you're the judge here, but I just got to tell you, that's a totally separate item. That's handled differently, it's set aside differently, it's cared for, it's protected with our life. You don't protect your toe with your life. But hammer gets our undivided attention. I actually have an alarm system. Warning, warning, you're too close. Back up. You know we care more about it because we name it. Here's a Shaquille O'Neal. Some call him Russell. Russell the Wonder Muscle. Mine is the GFS. It's Godfather Soul. All right, whose turn is it? Hey, when a woman isn't pretty, people always say she has a good what?
Real side.
Oh, I know exactly what you mean.
I know you do.
But you threw the judge into something.
A behind.
It, that's just two ways that were. It goes like this.
Nah,
then you go, fuck.
Yeah.
And then it's a hook back. Fuck. That's what they're looking for. A nice rear end. Name something you might have to jiggle to get it working.
We're going to say a man's private parts.
I promise you, when I walked over here, that never crossed my mind. There's just no way I figured that. I just, you know, I'm thinking of everything. Keys, toilet handles, I was flashlight. I'm thinking of objects that's, you know, the man's thing. Jennifer, only one strike. Name something the man of your dreams has that sadly your husband does not.
I'm gonna say, plug yours, Mom. Big
package. Big package. You make sense. Big package.
Brian, well,
You got this, B.
It's gonna be up there. It's gonna be up there.
Brian, come on, encourage him. B, we ask 100 men, name something you're not too proud to beg for.
Steve, I am not too proud to beg for a good job.
Job. Hey, Wesley, name something a man sees his wife by that makes him nervous.
Dildo.
You asked the question.
Good answer.
A dildo. When you get to heaven, what do you hope every man you meet has?
Hair.
Hair.
Sorry, Steve. Nothing personal, nothing personal.
Turn around. So you think, because you done drew all this in your head, you think you're going to heaven because of your hairstyle? Hair! Name something that's big and round. Marcus.
My stomach.
My stomach.
Bald head.
Huh?
Bald head.
Okay, sorry. Bald head. Now, if Santa went to a bar, who might be his wingman?
Chucky. Well, Santa gives a lot of dolls away, so maybe he just takes them.
Well, why would he bring this little evil bastard with him? What's Santa gonna do, walk in with Chucky? All right, either I get a date
or he gonna kill everybody in here. Name a way you like your desserts and your men.
Hard.
You got some meat? No. Play the music. Let's go. Get it open.
Get in there.
Not your leg. Don't put your leg on. Give me a term of affection people use for their mates. Come on.
Husband.
I hear you, Miss Mary. Miss Hell, I'm gonna say something, man.
Husband!
Well, look who's back.
Hey!
Kenny, how you doing, man? You ain't know what that was.
Yeah.
You ain't know. See, you don't know, did you?
Yeah.
See, you don't know what that is. Want me to tell you what
don't
that is?
Don't hurt him, Steve.
No, I'm going to tell him what that is. He a mime. Do a mime move for him.
Do a mime move?
Yeah, one mime. The worst mime I've ever seen. The worst.
There you go, Steve. Good job.
Come on, man. We asked 100 women, name a way you like your desserts and your men.
Strawberries.
Good answer. Yeah.
Ready? Here we go. Strawberry! He'll ever get one. Cause something wrong with Kenny. Kenny crazy. Name something women wear that was obviously designed by a man cause it's uncomfortable but sexy.
Mm. Texas, Steve. Texas.
Good answer!
Texas. It's up there. Right there.
Yeah. Okay. Just tell me what you said.
Texas, Steve. Yeah, Texas.
I mean, what?
You heard of the state?
The Texas. State, Texas.
Yeah.
T-E-X-A-S?
Mm-hmm. That's a good answer, Steve. Watch it. I'll teach you. Yes.
You from Tennessee?
Yeah. Texas.
I got you.
Boy, you crazy. Fill in the blank. Never ever have I what?
Slept with an elephant.
Besides chicken, name a bird people eat.
Venison.
Name something that ends with the word pit.
Pit bull.
And what would you be shocked come home and see your wife wearing?
Another man, Steve.
Name something in your bedroom that would be weird if it glowed in the dark.
My genitalia.
Name something you'd hate to fall off of you in the middle of a hot date.
Come on, Kevin. A chair.
Name something that follows the word spare.
Frank. Breakfast.
Spare breakfast. That's the extra one. That's the one sitting over there on the table. Ain't nobody touching.
That's right.
Get spare breakfast. Besides a bull, name an animal that has bull in its name.
Angel bull.
What?
Angel bull.
A bull angel.
Yeah.
The hell are you talking about? Angel bull. Anybody.
I mean, that was a good answer.
No, it ain't anybody. Anybody, shut up, it's not up there. Name something a man finds in the house that makes him suspect his wife might kill him. Brittany.
Another woman's panties.
Steal. An animal a farmer's wife says the farmer acts like in the bedroom.
Spaghetti.
Name something a man quickly hides under the bed when his wife enters the bedroom.
The fact that he's naked.
Name a word that rhymes with fudge.
Mud.
Victor.
Mud.
Mud. Brenda, name something some people buy and some people make at home.
Bruce Springsteen. I don't know.
Julie, give me a B word that describes your bottom.
Rump.
Ooh.
Huh?
Rump.
A B word.
Oh, a B word.
And when a man comes home, he'd see a note from his wife that says, gone to where?
A loss of his family.
They said, be with it.
It's the life, Steve. Man.
Name something women can't do as well as men. William.
Drive.
Drive.
That's a play.
They're going to play. Name something of yours that's old and smells funny.
Some old friends.
some old friends. There's a store that sold husbands. Most people would try to buy one that came with a good what?
Good head of hair.
A good head of hair. Hair don't make a man. There's one answer left. So me. If that was a store that sold husbands, most people would try to buy one that came with a good what?
Sorry, Mom, but package.
They're saying that that's the same thing as body. Okay. Me and you know it ain't. Oh, you can have a good body. Hey, you ain't got to have a good body, though. You know what I'm saying? I ain't all that right here. Oh, Lord, Jesus. Woo! Woo! Sometimes I get out the shower, I just stand there 10,
that's
15
right.
minutes. I can't believe I say some of the stuff I say. Name a phrase it takes courage to say for the first time.
I'm gonna say expletive you.
That one right there, the expletive you word. Name something a woman might put in her man's underwear as a prank.
Cream.
Cream. Name something you might wait to do in a movie theater until the lights go out.
Start videotaping the movie.
Damn. Well, I guess the pastor working on the building thing. Oh, the pastor that came up with a hustle to finally get that new addition built onto the church. Pastor selling bootleg movies right after service.
We don't do it.
Record the movie. Name something the man of your dream has, your husband sadly does not.
Hair, Steve.
Come on, come on.
You know,
my husband got hair.
You know, you can have, you know, the man of
That's
your dreams
right.
cannot have hair.
Mm-hmm.
I don't really care who in your family got hair.
Got it.
Hair! Name some news you'd hear about your neighbor that you would consider juicy gossip.
A death.
A death. Rashad.
He's a murderer.
It's time to move, Steve. It's time to move.
He's a murderer. What would Santa be shocked to discover the elves were making? Melissa.
Condoms.
Elves just in there just making damn condoms. What the hell? How did that come out your head like that? You don't know. You just Melissa thinks that the little elves is in the back and they put all the toys and hammers down and just making little rubber things with the little tips on them and making condoms. How do you do? What do you do for a living, ma'am?
I work for Social Security.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
That's good. You behind that window?
No, I work upstairs.
Oh, you don't have to deal with the public?
No, but I'd love to.
No, you don't. Don't ever say that. Dealing with us is not a good job. Anytime you got to work behind 8 inches of plexiglass, that ain't nothing good about that. Them people downstairs, no.
Yeah,
it's best you
but
upstairs.
That's a promotion.
What?
To work downstairs.
That's a promotion?
Yes. Yes.
Michelle, who told you that?
The job title.
Listen to me. That ain't a promotion.
To go down.
No. That's a sentence. That's like a prison term. Whenever you got to come out front and deal with the people in the public, that is not a promotion. I don't know what they told you down there. You get a promotion, you go up. Ain't no promotion downstairs.
Okay.
All right, let's go, Miss Sharon. Hey, if someone pulls into a parking spot you were waiting for, what would you be tempted to do?
Flatten their tires.
Flatten their tires.
Yes, and then I pray about it.
You'll flatten their tires, then pray about it.
Yes, I would.
Yeah. You don't need to be behind that glass window. You stay where you at. Flatten their tires. I'd like to run into my ex-boyfriend with a what?
Car.
We talked to 100 women. Name something you'd do to a guy who dumped you on your birthday.
I would bust the windows out his car.
If someone pulls into a parking spot you were waiting for, what would you be tempted to do?
I would be tempted to key their car, see? Yeah.
I would do like Jasmine Sullivan and bust the windows out their car.
Hit them.
Physically hit them.
Yeah! Physically hit them in your job. Now, we ask 100 single women, I'd like to run into my ex-boyfriend with a what?
A hammer.
Hey, Kim, name a lost item you'd hate to see sticking out of your cat's litter box.
Dinner. Dinner. Oh, yeah. Oh man. I would be mad.
Yeah. You'd be furious with that.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Oh, that'd be nasty.
That's crazy, ain't it?
Yeah.
Girl, because you done went over there to the table, and all of a sudden, your dinner ain't there no more. And you've been looking all over the house for your dinner, and it's in that damn litter box.
Yeah,
Kim, okay, yes. So Kim, listen to me. See, I said name a lost item that you'd hate to see sticking up out the cat's litter box.
This is number 8. It's number 8. That's up there. Yeah. It's gonna be number 8. I'm telling you, sir. Right? Yeah, number 8. Yes. Yes, sir. Yes. Number 8. There's 2 people that said this. Yes. Yes.
So.
It's a good answer.
You're banking that 2 people have thought The same thing.
I'm feeling very confident.
Kim.
Yep.
Let's see. If you walk over there and your dinner is sticking up out.
Yeah. Yeah. Seriously. Girls.
Yeah. The little box.
Yeah.
Your dinner.
Yeah.
Oh!
What? That, no way.
When a husband and wife have an argument, what usually happens at the end of the argument?
The husband says, I'm sorry.
Yes, yes, yes! Yes!
24 years, 24
Always.
Years.
Always. You right. just say, I'm sorry.
Me.
She can be dead wrong. You have to say, you're sorry.
I'm sorry.
Come on, boy. Come on, Kenny, show up. Top eight answers on the board. Name something a sneaky dog catcher might disguise himself as. Kenny.
A cat.
A cat. Jack.
I'm saying another dog.
Another dog.
We're gonna play, Steve.
We're gonna play. Man. Man. Now I gotta go back over here. Yeah. Name something that's long and wet. Victor. Pepe.
My,
If you were playing doctor, name a specific kind of doctor you wouldn't want to be.
I wouldn't want to be a foot doctor.
Yeah, Dad! Yeah. Daddy, I'm 8 feet!
Huh? You gotta have the name of the doctor. You gotta...
I cannot, I'm sorry, I don't know the name of a foot doctor. Why did I pick that answer? podiatrist.
Yes!
Oh my gosh!
Yes!
You got it!
That was it! That was it!
Oh my gosh! Shut the bus.
Yes, I got that. Yes, I got that. Let's see if it's up there.
Podiatrist.
Whoa.
The father just said, I pulled it out of my butt. And that, sir, would be a proctologist.
That would...
All right, Dawson, name something that can be soft or hard. Super cool Uncle Ray, better known as the Quiet Storm. Name something about Peter Pan that's different from the average boy.
Make good peanut butter.
Yeah, name something you toss.
Toss them draws.
Toss them draws! A good stage name for a stripper would be Blank Buns.
The only thing I can think of is Sticky. Oh!
Good answer! Good answer! Good answer! Good answer!
That's the only thing I got! That's the only thing I got! I know it's not favorable, but, you know, it happens, right?
Allison, where are you going with this? You know, just say your answer. I didn't ask you, what do you mean by that? I didn't do nothing. I was just going to let the audience write their own joke. Well, you know, it happens, though. Sticky buns! Name something a wife might do at her cheating husband's funeral.
Close the casket.
Close the casket. Close the case. If you had a tail, name a place you go where it would be wagging.
If I was a dog.
He's talking about the beach. But I would go to the beach.
But listen to
if
me.
A dog go to the beach, he's going to be happy.
But Alan, you know what I'm saying? Listen to me. But Alan, listen to me. What? Nobody said a damn thing about you being a damn dog.
But that's where I'm going.
Yeah, okay.
That's,
well, we're
I'm thinking like a dog. Because I got a tail.
But no, we ain't, it ain't said nothing about no damn dog. That ain't had to go be in there. Now, Alan, it said if you had a tail, he ain't say nothing about you being no damn dog.
I understand all that, but beach. Beach.
Beach! When it comes to grooming, name something you wish your husband would do more often.
His eyebrows.
What? His eyebrows?
Yes!
His eyebrows.
Yes!
Name the most embarrassing place someone might ask to take a selfie with me.
Cemetery.
Hold up, dog. Don't throw the dirt on the chip. Let me ask you something. Can you open it right quick? Cemetery. Pretty good, man. What do you do for a living, Chuck?
I'm a farmer.
Oh, that's right. Farmers.
Well,
I love farmers.
Yep. Well,
I grew up on a farm.
I farm in Moonshine Township, Steve, and that's appropriate because we raise a lot of corn, and we turn our corn into 200-proof alcohol at a local farmer-owned co-op.
But it was crazy. Why did everybody clap? They said 200 proof. Woo! Oh, yeah! Just need one shot of that. Man, the reason a woman might save a date last night reminded me of Steve Harvey.
Money smile.
Steve, we're going to say smile.
I smile.
Oh, no. No.
I like that one right there. Number six.
Loud and chatty.
I'm the host of the show. What the hell am I supposed to do? Number three. Name something you wish your hubby would do just in the bathroom, not everywhere.
Men are often moving themselves around, adjusting themselves. In public, you see them walking down the street. They do! They do!
So you want him to just do that in the bathroom?
Yeah, don't walk around.
Yeah, but see. In the morning when you get dressed, everything's fine. But then your day is going, you know, and you sit down, you cross your legs, you get up, you bend over.
Life's hard.
Yeah.
Life's hard.
This is going the other way, folks. Adjusting themselves. Well, Ms. Joy.
Hey, Mr. Steve.
Hey, all right,
hey, Matt.
Ms. Joyce, so how'd you come up with the idea?
My hairstylist did.
Oh,
I just
okay.
sit down
just
in her chair,
down.
Close my ass, tell her, hook me
now
up.
I'll be damned. She just sat down in her stylist chair and just said, go on, do you.
Right. This is how I roll, Steve.
This it.
This is it. This is me.
The celebrity of the family, everybody love her. You sat down in the hairstylist chair and just said, girl, do you. Now we out here, she on TV as Pepe Le Pew. Y'all supported this.
Yes, we're all the sisters.
Oh, all y'all sisters.
United. Yes,
United. All the three of y'all
family,
sisters.
Family, baby.
Oh,
family.
Watch out now.
Double D's. Yes.
Double D's.
That's right. That was
all right, let's go. Brian, name something a woman gets rid of when she wants to jumpstart a love life.
Vibrator. Sorry, Steve.
It's your answer. You say what you want to say. Vibrator.
You ready, Steve?
I don't know. It's hard to be a woman, but name a reason you wouldn't want to be a man.
Got to work hard.
Oh, oh, no, you didn't. Sister, sister.
Got to work hard.
Body odor.
Body odor. Body odor.
We're gonna play, Steve.
Okay, great. I wouldn't have said your answer. Not the first one. That couldn't have been the first thing pop out my damn mouth. When you say, gotta work hard, all the women in here went, oh, okay. Oh, and we don't? I said, oh, boy. All right, Erica, we talked to 100 women. It's hard to be a woman. Name a reason you wouldn't want to be a man.
Their private card?
Yeah.
I'm perfectly fine to me. Tell you one thing.
But they asked the women.
Tell you one thing. Don't want to live my life without him. I'll tell you that right now. Your body part.
Back at you.
Number 7.
Hey, go, go!
That's not funny. Yoshiba, the party doesn't really get started until you see people doing what?
Falling asleep.
What?
Falling asleep.
Falling asleep. Falling asleep. Annette, yes. Talk to 100 married women. Name something your husband has that would hurt his feelings if you made fun of him.
An ugly mother.
these Georgia answers right here. Your mother ugly. Hurt your feelings good. This is you and your ugly mama. Name something a man rides on for which he might consider wearing a protective cup.
Those toys with the stick and you ride them around. You know what, the horse?
You ride a stick? I gotta hear more about this. This is fascinating. What do you mean?
It's like an animal with a stick, and you pretend like you're a cowboy.
A horse. On oh, like the stick with the little head on it, and
the
you do like
head.
That.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know what you were talking about. You drag it behind? That's an old-ass toy. That's some 1954 Leave It to Beaver. I'm old as hell. I ain't even have one of them. I didn't know. I might be there. I didn't know. It's good. I don't know. I don't even know what to call it. It's a thing that you ride on that the kids rode on in the 50s, and you never see them anymore. Because they're obsolete and they're old. And there's video games out now. And who the hell would buy their kid one of them little poor sticks? You gotta be the poorest family in the neighborhood. That one. Yeah. Name an animal that could fit in your underwear.
How about a baby kitten?
Yeah! Yeah. Yeah.
Baby kitten. With the claws? Ma'am, I gotta tell you something.
You wanna buy something?
A baby kitten.
Nailed it.
What guy? I'm take his cat. I'm gonna pack it down in my drawer, see how long I can take it. You put a cat in your drawer? Hey, we'll try. Okay, we might try the hamster. Got that, the mouse, got that. I don't really see me doing any of this. But what we ain't sticking down in my shorts is something with some claws on it. You pull that puppy out. Sharp shirt and tie combination.
Well, thank you. This,
boy,
my wife bought it. This is the best I look since I got married. Probably won't look as good again till I'm laid out.
One answer left.
The titties right. Thing, shorty.
If it's there, your face. Where did that come from, Fred?
I'm excited, man. We're gonna get this money.
He been just conservative the whole day.
I know.
Then all of a sudden, get this dang shorty. What would you do if you had a big date, no sexy underwear?
Cancel the date.
Cancel the date. Hello? Hello, Harold. Hey, it's Nicole. Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm fine. I ain't gonna be able to make it tonight. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I ain't got no drawers.
Let me see again. It's up there.
No drawers.
It's up there, Steve.
Boy, you so crazy. Cancel the date. Name something a cowboy does to his woman and his horse.
Michael.
He rides him, Steve. Come on, baby. Number one, he rides him. Nadine, name something you'd hate to discover about a hitchhiker right after you picked him up.
He's carrying a dead body.
Good answer.
The hell did you pick him up for? Get in. Oh, by the way, what is that over your shoulder? It's a dead body. Well, I don't want to give both of you a ride. Well, he's carrying a dead body. Name something you do. You saw your husband wearing thong underwear.
You know, typically when I catch my husband wearing thong underwear, I'll take him back.
Got my damn thongs on. Sitting up in here, and I'm sitting up in here trying to get myself together. These belong to me. Sitting up in here. They stretched them all out of shape and everything. Craig said, take them back. Well, if Michael Jordan's the best basketball player of all time, who's second best?
Dennis Rodman.
What?
They took my answer.
Oh, they took your answer.
They did.
Oh, okay, and I understand. You're not a huge sport fan. No. Dennis Rodman. You know that he asked, no damn chance of being up here. Okay. So instead of pulling my shirt all out my pants, pointing at that, we just gonna forget about
over.
That. We'll pass it on over here. You ready to just take it?
Yeah.
But just handle that. It's gonna be a little short X. It's not gonna make a lot of noise. It's just, we're gonna try to get him doing like that. We're just trying to get him like that.
Yeah.
You know, instead of just, we ain't gonna do you like that.
Yeah.
What we're gonna do, we're just gonna go, we're just gonna try to do it like
that's
that.
It.
Okay? Sound person, could we try to just do it a little bit? Because just a little short. Okay, here we go. Dennis Rodman! Name an office supply you use to pick food out your teeth.
A paperweight.
Yeah. Yeah. But I don't get nothing else stuck in my damn mouth. Because I'm finna knock every last one of these. I'm sick of this meat all in the back of my teeth. I'm gonna put an end to this. Somebody give me that damn paperweight. Bust yourself.
They have a gap.
They got a gap.
Well, dentures. A gap with dentures.
Boy,
they...
shut up.
All right.
Paperweight. Doctor's fooling around with his nurse. Name something in the office they might use.
The lubrication.
Got by me, the host never even thought of that. I'm pretty good at this. I play this game every day. Ooh. Excuse me. The lubrication. Okay. That was loud and clear. Everybody clear on that? Everybody? Everybody, did you hear it? Lubrication.
Thermometer.
Gotta check the temperature. Gotta check that temperature.
Always.
I'm with you, boy. I gotta check the temperature. Gotta check that temperature. Yeah. Put this right here. Lift your tongue up. Say I. Let's check that temperature with that thermometer. Darling, we gotta be careful, darling. You got two strikes. The Villafranca family can steal
his office.
What does she mean? The hell, I don't know that crazy answer. See, here's the question. If the doctor is fooling around with his nurse, name something in the office they might use. The office! The whole damn office, just everything in there. All up in the windows, on the walls. You wanted to be more specific? More specific.
Well, use the office to hide. If the exam rooms are taken up, he's got to go somewhere and play.
You're gonna go to hide in the office in case the exam rooms is taken. Name something you've considered paying money to get rid of.
Karen. Your children.
Your children. Rick.
Your spouse.
You're funny.
Not me. Not me. Attorney fee.
Damn, Nancy Grace gonna be busy as hell. Name a way you might be able to tell a man is married just by looking at him.
The way he talks.
The way he talks.
Could be up to an issue. I like it.
Oh, they wanna know what you mean by that.
What he's saying.
The way he talk.
The...
What he's saying. Be more specific.
He's running game. He's...
These producers are white.
Oh. Oops.
Ha ha ha. Yeah, whatever. Y'all can help her.
He uses we a lot.
Instead of saying I, he says we a lot. As he's talking, he's talking about when we go places, when we...
Okay. We! Name a famous horse that a well-endowed male stripper might call himself.
Black Beauty.
Hell yeah. Yeah. Hell yeah. Thank you so much, folks. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, my God, I didn't think you'd think of me. Ladies and gentlemen, Black Beauty. Name something that sports teams do to players that husbands wish they could do to their wives. Ready?
Hit them. Like, hit them, boom.
Good answer.
You know? Thinking football?
Hit them. Okay, Shari, name something women wear that was obviously designed by a man because it's uncomfortable but sexy.
High heels.
Yes. Yeah. Greatest invention of all times. High heels. High heel shoes. Hey, Reggie. Name something women wear that was obviously designed by a man because it's uncomfortable but sexy.
A thong.
Second greatest invention. A thong with the high heel shoes on. Name a place a man likes to go that he couldn't enjoy if his wife came with him.
I'm gonna say the bathroom.
You know how good an answer that really is, though. You ever had your wife open the door and start talking to you? What? Close the door.
Exactly.
The bathroom. Yeah! Name something that goes up that you hope will come down.
My parents are gonna kill me, but a male's body part. My sister. That was good, right?
Are your parents over there?
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah. Oh, now they're pointing down the aunt. She's a mom right there. All of the aunts. She's not mine. She belong her right there. Male body part. Name something of yours that disappoints you every time you look at it.
All right, it's not me, but my kids. Not me.
Folks,
what do we do?
Part of a fish you wouldn't want to find in your fish taco.
The part he uses to go to the bathroom with.
That's right. Good answer.
The butt.
Fish butt.
Yes, good answer, Benaiah. Good answer, Benaiah.
I've been fishing probably. Gotta be at least 50 years I've been fishing. I done cut up a lot of fish. Ain't never had to take butt off before. Fish butt! If dogs use computers, what would they post pictures of on the internet? Terrell.
The girlfriend cat, a cat.
The girlfriend cat. That's amazing how you thought of that. I can't respond to it because such a different answer. I've seen Stranger Things. The girlfriend cat. Name the first woman who might be inducted into the Booty Hall of Fame.
Michelle Obama.
Can't put Michelle Obama in no damn hall, booty hall of fame.
Yes.
This woman got 4 degrees. She been the first lady.
And a good booty.
She got 4 degrees and a good booty.
Shut up. Can't put Michelle Obama in that. We're not gonna drag Michelle Obama name into this ignorant ass survey.
Watch, she's up there.
She ain't up there.
Yes, yes.
No, she's not. Michelle Obama.
Oh.
All right, we go. Yeah, Mr. Potato Head plays strip poker. What's the first thing to go?
His big lips.
Yeah.
Good answer.
Miss Debs, it started with the way you looked at me. Then, after you gave your answer, you did this. You know, like if you pull yours in, it might soften the blow for me. I've been attacked my entire life about my facial features. I have been Mr. Potato Head damn near my whole life. But then she gonna lean in the mic. His big lips. Thank you, Miss Deb. Your big lips. Some men are chick magnets. What might make a man a chick repellent?
Bad personality.
He got a bad personality. Number seven.
Smoke
cigars. Number six.
Bad hair, bald.
What the hell? You got what? Hey, hey. Really? You got a problem with cigar? Now I'm bald head? Why don't we just put big lips on that? Number four, big ass lips. Say it. I swear to God, say it. Name an object that's the size of Steve Harvey's head. Yeah, Tom.
A watermelon?
Watermelon.
It's all about the car, Steve.
Renee?
A bowling ball?
Shut up, Tom. Bowling ball! That's the
play. We're gonna play, Steve.
We're gonna play. Brian?
Yes, sir.
You ain't got one right all day long. Here's your chance, buddy. Name an object that's the size of Steve Harvey's head. This sucks.
Well, a helmet.
A helmet to go on top of somebody's head ought to bust you in your mouth. Damn head ain't big as no damn helmet. I hope it ain't up there. A helmet! Name an object that's the size of Steve Harvey's head.
A hiney cheek. One hiney cheek.
One tiny cheek.
That's my mouth.
My head look like the half of somebody else. My head look like half just somebody else.
Please be there.
Better not be there. I'll tear this down. If it's up there, I'll tear this damn board down. Steve Harvey's head look like half of somebody's ass. Okay, here we go. A kid might say, I saw. I'm reading the question. Man, I got a headache messing with these two families right here. Name a reason you'd like to see Steve Harvey perform at Chippendales. Oh, and then the slow ass response. Yeah.
I thought there was more to the question.
Oh, yes.
Your package.
Yeah. I don't care if it ain't up there. Good answer. Number one.
Sorry.
I take my clothes off, start dancing at Chippendales. You know how many fans I'm gonna lose. Kathy, we asked 100 women, name a reason you like to see Steve Harvey perform at Chippendales.
Rip your clothes off.
You just want me to rip my clothes
That's
off.
That's right.
You better watch yourself. You better go on, girl. You've been just sitting up watching Family Feud talking about, I want to just rip his clothes off. Tear my clothes off, Miss Kathy. All right, talk to 100 women. Name a reason you'd like to see Steve Harvey perform at Chippendales.
So I can get a lap dance from you.
The little nursing girl want a lap dance. On the roll, if your dog ran away, name something you'd be surprised he took with him.
Is blanket the same as clothes?
I don't know.
Okay, blanket.
Well, I'm just the host, lady. I'm just the host. The hell if I know. I feel if you wrap him in it, I don't know if you got it wrapped around him. I don't know how you do your dog.
But if he's invisible, it's okay.
If he's invisible, I do the jokes, lady. I do the jokes. Would you mad women name something your husband has that would hurt his feelings if you made fun of it?
Bald head.
What the hell are you laughing at? That hard. I can't breathe. Bald head.
I love you, Steve.
My handsome husband.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Best looking damn dude ever been on Family Feud. Boy, let me tell you something.
Hey, let me say something to you.
Boy, you don't look like my dad, brother. Boy. Go ahead, Marshall. I'm listening.
First of all, I want to tell you. Uh-huh. And I'm secure within my masculinity to say this to you. You a sharp dresser, and you're a good-looking man, man. Well, you just made my day, man.
Boy, you don't understand. I ain't mad at you. Because soon as I walked out here, I said, damn, he cute. Name something a bald man might object to someone doing to his head. title?
Shaving It.
Shaving It.
Rubbing It.
Hate It. Rubbing It. All right, Miss Cynthia, name something a bald man might object somebody doing to his head.
Hitting it in the back.
You did that a million times?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay.
I'm experienced.
You know, man, my wife do that to me, too. Yeah.
You know, when you
like, if I, especially if I'm doing something, I'm on the phone, yes. I'm talking to somebody, and the conversation got a little crazy, she'll walk in and just slap me in the back of the head. And I spin real fast, because I think it's one of the kids playing. And then it's her, and I got, can't say nothing. Hit him in the back of the head. Bernard, only one strike. Name something a bald man might object to somebody doing to his head.
Patting it.
Patting it. I hate that. Yeah. Patting it. For a man to give his brother's wife.
Sex toy.
All these men.
That's what they told you.
That's what they told
them boys down there put you up to this.
I wasn't going with that, Steve.
You wasn't going to go with that?
No, I was going with something
else. Well, watch this. Sex toy! Name something the trucker keeps in the truck for those cross-country trips.
How about a sex magazine?
Good answer here. Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Now, Miss Rita. Miss Rita?
Yes, Steve?
You can't put this on the boys this time.
Okay.
Because you was out here by yourself on this answer. Now, the last time you said the boys put you up to it.
That's right, Steve.
And it was a sex toy. And it's a little spicy, and the people down at the church go.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's going to get
out. And
I
go to church all the time,
I know,
Steve.
I could tell.
Yes,
you,
indeed.
You a God-fearer.
Yes, I am.
Yes,
I got the, and I go to the best church in San Pedro.
Yeah, what is that?
Mount Sinai Missionary Baptist Church. Pastor Leo Thomas.
Yes.
Yeah. And I'm the president of the usher board.
You're the president of the usher board.
I'm the president of the usher board.
Did they have suspensions?
Yeah.
Because I think after they hear this answer, you're going to be out for a little while.
You think so?
Yeah.
They're going to sit me down?
Yeah, I think they're going to sit you down for a little while, but it ain't going to be long, though.
Okay.
It's okay. Sometimes y'all take a little couple Sundays off.
I understand.
You know, go to game or something, you know.
But I'm doing it for the team, Steve.
You're doing it for the team,
yes.
Too. Well, as long as they believe that down at the church, your second sex answer might be okay. Sex magazine! What might a man do if his ex-wife was telling everyone that he has a teeny weeny?
Sue him.
Sue him. Max.
Kill her.
Max gonna shut this down. Now, this little statement about me goes no further today. You're dead. Killer!
No kids visitation. She's not allowed to see the kids.
These babies with this woman. Now, you can't see your kids because you got a teeny weeny. No need to visitation, buddy. Eric, what might a man do if his ex-wife was telling everybody he has a teeny weeny?
Got to release a video. Got to release the video, Steve. Got to release the video. Is it a good answer?
They my kids, they.
You said you high-fiving your boys.
You would do the same.
You're a father. You can't say that. Don't have your boy releasing the video. You've got Max already gonna kill somebody. I'm gonna. Eric gonna make a video. I'll show you. Sherry, when I went to the doctor, he told me I should have my blank examined.
butthole.
Miss Devil, if a woman chooses a man like she chooses fruits and vegetables, name something she do to him before a first date.
Taste him, Steve. Taste him. Yes.
I just can't do none of my jokes because you thought it was a good idea to let the pastor come on the show.
Yes, sir.
Now she doing little nasty jokes. I can't say nothing. Taste them, Steve, what you want me to say now. I got to deal with the fact that she a pastor, so I don't go to hell. Unless I'm on the plan. Taste them, Steve. Yeah.
Then marry 40.
All right, James, if a woman chooses a man like she chooses fruits and vegetables, name something she'd do to him before a first date.
Feel him.
Good answer. Yeah.
Go on, get in the car. Feel him. Name something at a supermarket a man might squeeze a little too romantically.
The meat.
You know, like a chicken breast. A chicken breast.
Nisi. He betrayed me. I'm thinking it's nice, warm, and safe over here with the Oliver family. The meat. Squeeze that meat. Your meat in your hand. The meat. Why do they say you're funny? You're the funny one?
Make jokes about everybody in the family. We have some characters.
Do you?
Yes.
Who? Like, y'all got an uncle that...
Oh, yeah.
That's the one. Everybody got
really
that.
Got
all you
got
to do
uncle.
Is ask about that uncle.
Yeah,
everybody
got a few
everybody got an uncle that ain't rapped but three times. Yeah. What's his name?
Uncle Juice.
Ooh, they all knew it. Uncle Juice. You already know something wrong. What grown man named Juice? He watching Family Feud right now. What are you on TV? My family on TV. All right, how you doing, man?
Good. How about yourself?
Yeah, still happy, huh?
I'm still happy.
Yeah. The reason I love him is he looks just like the dude on that box of my favorite cereal, which was Super Sugar Crisp. He looks like the bear. My man. Get to me one time, Mike. Yeah. My dude right here, man. All right, Mike, that was a wild party last night at the nursing home, and I know you know everybody got what?
Broken hips.
Broken hips. A grandma might store in her cleavage.
Crackers.
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 Come here, kids. Grandmama got a treat for you. Eat it, eat it! Stop crying, shut up crying and eat the cracker. It's your grandmama, it's safe. Blow on it a little bit and eat the cracker. Grandmama reached down in there and pulled a cracker out of her cleavage. Sharon, two strikes, gotta be careful, the other family can steal. Give me something on your body you're glad you only had one of.
Vagina, Steve.
Jesus. But you thought after butthole.
Hey.
You thought since butthole was up there, you just gonna just go down the line?
Yes, Steve.
Vagina. Name something someone might hand you at a wild party.
Hors d'oeuvres.
Hors d'oeuvres.
That's right.
What's the name of that school you went to again? What's the name of that school?
Oswego State University. Yeah. That's one
and
of them.
And them wild parties down there passing out them damn hors d'oeuvres. Woo! I was up on them hors d'oeuvres. I couldn't take another hors d'oeuvre. Girl, you give me one more hors d'oeuvre, I'ma turn this damn party out. Understand? Woo! Boy, they had up in there, man. We had beers, we had hors d'oeuvres. Woo! We was in there, woo, clowning. Cornelius at his parties, they was at wild parties, passing out hors d'oeuvres. Oh, yeah. Name a place on the body where women bleach their hair.
I'm gonna say their butt crack.
You know, Jared, I really, you shouldn't have said that. Right? Oh, Jared, you don't know.
It's up there.
The hell. And please don't say it's up there. You're digging this hole way deeper. It's up there. Way, way up there. Bleaching the hair on the booty. Name something you pull out.
Your penis.
Your wife, Nate.
Yeah.
Your thing, she said. Name something a rabbit might do in a magician's hat.
Fly away.
Yeah, good answer.
Yes. Fly away.
Fly away.
Yeah.
Did you hear the question? Name something that a rabbit might do in the magician's hat. Anybody said nothing about name something that the dove might do in the magician's hat. The hell the rabbit gonna fly away? How? Y'all getting the huddling come up with? Here we go, damn roll tide roll. Here we go. Right there. I'm telling you, it's a lot of war eagles watching this laughing real hard right now. Telling you right now, you think that rabbit gonna fly out that damn hat? Do you know how rich that magician will be? You got a rabbit, y'all, that's about to fly out that. Just take off. I ain't doing these damn tricks no more. I'm flying. I'm getting out of here. I'm tired of this. I've always wanted to be a bird any damn way. I'm out of here. The rabbit fly away out the hat. Kevin?
Steve?
Tell me the last thing you stuck your finger in.
My wife, Steve. It's up there, Steve.
Yeah. That's my what? Boy, Steve.
You say it's up
it's
there.
It's up there, Steve.
Yeah, okay. You okay, man? Number one! Kale?
Yes, sir.
I've had a lot of good answers.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It's my favorite answer of all time. Don't do that no more.
Don't do that.
Let that be a Steve.
Ryan?
Yes, sir.
Tell me the last thing stuck your finger in.
No, sir.
Say, no, sir. No, sir. No, we're no, sir. All these is exits. All this exits. Okay.
After me.